All right, so tonight I'd want to go to the fund management market and get some latest updates from the market. Of course, the coalition of aggrieved 53 collapsed fund management companies are up in arms with the Securities and Exchange Commission. They are totally not happy with some of the decisions that have been arrayed tonight. Joining me live in the studio are two members from the coalition. And here we have Joseph Aite, who is the secretary to the coalition, and Charles Nyame, who is the PRO. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me right here in the studio. So within activities that have been happening as part of it today, you met with the boss or director general of the Securities and Exchange Commission, all with the aim of ensuring that you retrieve your locked up funds. Now, they've mentioned that some of the institutions that were shut in the first place, they've called them back, or the alliances probably will be given back to them. But you are not certainly happy about some of the decisions going on. Share with us exactly what transpired at the meeting today.
Okay, so basically, Kweku, we've had this meeting about, the first meeting was about 3 weeks ago. So the assurance was that we were going to go into today's meeting with some specific promises going forward as to when our money is going to be paid to us and the structure they are going to use to pay our money for us. Today, when we went into the meeting, we tried to inquire from Reverend Ogbami Tete when and how, who is the Director General of SEC, when and how are these monies going to be paid? Because already customers have been suffering for over 2 years now. We don't have access to our money. Almost every single time you have one member dying or the other. You know, remember that majority of our members happen to be pensioners. Pensioners who have come out from their active employment and they are now home. These were monies they were supposed to use to fend for themselves whilst on retirement. Unfortunately, today when we went into the meeting, we asked the question of why even some of the licenses have been restored. Okay, basically what we sought to identify was that it looks like the revocation that was done was arbitrarily done. And the reason why we were saying that the revocation was arbitrarily done was that we remember that when the revocation was done, there was a public notice from the Securities and Exchange Commission citing specific reasons why these licenses were revoked.
But so, the committee has been said, the committee has listened to all the pros and cons of the institutions that were either to close. Sure. And they are saying that, no, I think you have a good case, reasons sure. why we should give back your license to you. Is that a problem with you?
So my point is that where was these committees and what were their role in the revocation? Because you, as the regulator, came up with specific reasons why you were revoking the license, to the extent that Reverend Ogbami Tete made us aware that they actually conducted a forensic audit on some of these cases. So if after conducting a forensic audit, you come back to tell me that you are restoring the licenses, especially when people have lost their lives as a result of your decision, okay, and we are going to place charges against the institution for the kind of injury and pain they have caused to customers.
Let me get to Charles Nyame a little bit. So, Charles, there's the assurance that your money will be paid. Reverend Ogbami Tete has told you that while they are putting themselves together, however, you were supposed to get information today, but for some reason it didn't happen today. Don't you think you should still give them some time while SEC resolves this book and try to pay you your funds?
Thank you. I think no. Because it has been over 2 years now, and the problem was not generated naturally. It was caused by this ruling government out of the president's policy, that's financial cleanup exercise. And the problem has been on their table for over 2 years now. So if over 2 years you have invited us, the meeting was not called at our instance. It was called at their instance, invited us. And in our previous meeting, we concluded that coming into this meeting, you are going to give us what structure of payment and when is the payment going to commence. In today's meeting, Reverend Ogbami Tete, excuse me with my words, has the guts to tell us that he doesn't know when payment is going to commence and he does not know the structure. The point is, for 2 years now, if this problem, national problem, killing people. People are losing their lives, losing their jobs, losing their families. Lying on your table and you have not prioritized it for 2 years. What time? Should we wait eternity? What ample time should we give to them again? We don't have time. You see, and we even asked him question that, is their activities bounded with timelines? And he couldn't answer the question. All that he has said that we should wait, we should wait, we should wait. But now I'm saying that we have an alternative option.
What's that alternative? I don't know.
Yeah.
A sec that is to ensure your money is paid. But if you say you have an alternative, what are you talking
about?
They
haven't shown any goodwill towards paying us. They haven't shown any goodwill.
But you mentioned that you have an alternative.
Yes, we have
are you going to court or what?
No, the alternative is that just recently, the opposition party President Mahama came out to say categorically that if we vote for him to come into power in his first year, he's going to pay every peswa in full.
Let me halt and ask you, Secretary, is this something you're also going by? It's just a promise given to you. Yeah. Why are you using it as a trump card now to say that, look, the former president has assured that this is what I'm going to do, so we are going to go by that? Are you not rather going to negotiate, engage with the government now and ensure that within this period to December when elections are conducted, you retrieve your money?
We are not ruling out the option of engaging the government to have our money paid to us. At the end of the day, we cannot even wait until next year when President Mahama comes into power before we receive our money. But I think the point Charles sought to make is that there is no good faith from the other party we are negotiating with. So certainly, if he's not showing us good faith, what options do we have available to us? But however, this does not also prevent us from still pushing, using all legitimate means to make sure that we get our money. And between now till elections, we are going to use every legitimate means available to us as citizens. Because you see, we cannot live in our own country and die in our own country. I think it is very, very unfair. We cannot invest money in our own country and somebody will come into power and claim that he is cleaning up a financial sector, and at the end of the day he revoke license and the next minute he begin restoring the licenses again. What are we talking about here? What due diligence went into the revocation for you to come back to tell us that you were restoring the licenses again? What due diligence? So it means that this was done based on parochial political interest. There was no good faith attached to the decision to revoke these licenses. And we want Reverend Obami Tete to come out to tell the Ghanaian public what basis he based his decision on in restoring this license. I think basically it is not fair. People are dead and gone because of Reverend Obami Tete's decision. And he tells us that he doesn't hold anybody responsible.
Reverend Obami is not here to justify this. Of course, we've tried talking to SEC also, and of course, they are like, they would want to hold on to this at the appropriate time. They would come up with a statement. I would only give you 30 seconds if the president is listening tonight or any stakeholder is listening tonight. Yeah. Shortly, what you'd want to tell them, and then we'll wrap it up.
Thank you very much. What we want to tell President Nana Akufo-Addo is that we are in this country, people just collect just 5 cedis and they either vote against a political party or they vote for political party.
Mm.
We are in this country, President Mahama was penalized based on power crisis that he did not deliberately cause. And we saw the results in the 2016 election. These monies that we are talking about are people's sweat, their lifetime savings. And it has been deliberately locked up out of his decision. So we want to tell him that there is no way the MPP government led by President Akufo-Addo can enter into this 2020 December election race with a clean house, leaving our problem fund management customers, our problem unresolved. Because if we get to that point, then we will show them that the power in this sovereignty resides in the citizens. Right. And we give it to whoever we wish to.
Thank you very much. Charles Nyame is a PRO of the association. In fact, they are the 53 collapsed fund management companies who have decided to come together and ensure that at the end of the day, they retrieve their locked up capital. They are just coming in from a meeting with the SEC Director General, the DG of SEC, Reverend Obami Tete. I would also mention that Joseph Aite is the secretary to the association. Gentlemen, thank you very much and we wish you well as you